You know what I've been seeing a lot around here on the Star Wars show celebration floor? Toys. Everyone's been carrying around big bags of toys, and I can't even go shopping. One of those people that we have to thank for this is right here with me right now, Steve Evans from Hasbro. How you doing, Steve?
Hi, I'm good, Andy. No one's too old for toys, right? Yeah, no, no growing up. No growing up allowed.
We're all 12 years old, right?
Yeah.
All of us. Well, welcome back to the celebration stage. We had you up in London, and it was a lot of fun.
We did. Thank you. Nice to see you again.
Yeah, nice to see you. And this year, you brought with you the celebration exclusive Luke Skywalker.
I did. I brought Luke along for the game.
Perfect.
Why not?
Tell us a little bit about this Luke here.
Yeah, so everyone knows it's the 40th anniversary today, or this year, of Star Wars. But if little thing people didn't know, it's the 4th anniversary of our Black Series line. And our first ever figure is our Luke Skywalker and X-Wing pilot. And we thought it fitting that here, with all these fine people, is to bring back our first figure and make him a celebration exclusive.
Now, is there anything different about this figure than the original release?
Just that we're putting him back on vintage-type packaging.
Okay.
With a nice metallic finish. He's also, as I said, the first Black Series figure we had, and people find it a little bit difficult getting hold of him. So we thought we'd bring some of those back and allow people a second chance.
You're welcome.
You're welcome,
guys. So as design director, you're pretty much responsible for creating and designing all of the Star Wars toys. You know,
not just me. It's a big team.
It's a team, but you're here representing your team.
Yes.
You know, how does all that happen? You know, what's that process like when you take something like a Luke Skywalker and try and make him that big?
A lot of talking, a lot of imagining, a lot of dreaming at the beginning. Like, we'll sit around, we'll grab some coffees, and we'll think, what should we make? What should we do next? Like, there's so many characters, so many ships, so many worlds within the Star Wars universe.
Like Kitster?
You and Kitster.
I had to do
one day, okay.
Please, I'm sure, like...
Do you still have that hashtag Kitster?
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
I feel like there's dozens of people who want him. Yeah. See? Yeah.
Oh, put me on the spot. Put me right on the spot. All right. So we have dreams, and we take special requests, and and we decide, like, what are we going to do? And there's so many characters. It's almost impossible. Like, who are we going to do? So then we chat to our friends at Lucasfilm, and we say, hey, we fancy doing this, whether it's an A-list kind of character, or whether we're going to do a sort of a little bit more obscure background character like we're seeing a lot over there in Jabba's Palace. And we'll speak with Lucasfilm, and we'll do some sketches, and then we'll get some reference, which is always the fun bit, getting the references either from the new films or from the vault up at Lucasfilm in San Francisco. And then we'll start sculpting, and we use ZBrush software, and we get it all sculpted in, we check in, check out. And it's a long process. It takes probably about a year, 18 months from one of us going, we should do her, to it being on the shelf and these fine people getting hold of it.
So, for example, when you were working on, like, the Force Awakens line of toys, how like far into the process of like the movie's release did you start developing the merch for that
film? It's pretty parallel, I'll be honest with you. The length of time it takes for sort of principal photography and post and us making a physical plastic toy happens simultaneously. So there's a lot of kind of parallel pathing, and you know, costumes may change as soon as an actor walks on set. You know, if the director wants a certain way, and we try our best to react to that. Unfortunately, some people get cut on the editing floor. Zuvio.
Who's got their Zuvios? No.
Dang. Oh, one person there, thank you very much.
Thanks guys. So, Zuvio thanks you.
So, you know, that's just part and parcel. That's what makes it fun.
Yeah,
the little stories like that, like, oh, he's not in the movie, but there's an action figure. But we have loads of others that are in the movie, and, you know, it's great finding out the new characters.
So how closely do you work with Lucasfilm to create these toys? Do they consult on, like, every tiny detail, or is it more of just, like, a concepting thing?
No, it's very collaborative. I mean, because it's new to them in a way, because a lot of them are new characters if you talk about new movies, and it's new to us, so we're like always asking questions, what's this, what's that prop for, what does that do, like what sort of fighting style does this person have, like what is that weapon? So it's constant, it's daily. I'm always ringing up Lucasfilm and saying, what's this do, why does that do that?
Some of the Black Series figures that have really excited me recently are the Rebels line. They're so good.
Thank you.
They're so beautiful. Ahsoka, I have Ahsoka, Kanan, and Sabine all lined up next to my prototype,
nice.
Boba Fett. How do you go about translating an animated character into their lifelike representation?
Well, doing Star Wars is a fantastic, and creatively doing Rebels into Black Series is like an extra cherry on top of the cake, because we don't replicate the look. We're not making maquettes of the animation show. We're taking the character and putting it into the Black Series universe, which is purposely off the screen, so lifelike. So taking Ahsoka, taking Hera, taking Sabine, taking Thrawn, which we announced yesterday.
Ooh.
And it's like...
I'm going to have to get that.
Yeah, no, he's cool. He's cool. We got some interesting things with him. Anyway, talk about that maybe later on. Making them real. Like, we'll take actresses and actors' likenesses and take inspiration and, like, how do you make it real? So that's actually a really good creative problem to have.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
Is there a figure that you're, like, dying to make, but everyone in the office is like, Steve, no, man. Come on. Nobody cares.
Oh, there's all... I quite like making, like, a tall Snaggletooth. Like,
a
the blue Snaggletooth.
Okay.
I'd like to do that.
That just would
because,
be cool.
Just because that's a great story from yesteryear, from, like, 40 years ago, where, you know, the guys in the team, you know, Mark Boudreau is still on the Hasbro team. He's been doing it 40 years. He was part of that team that had that first black and white photograph of Snaggletooth waist up to do for the Sears Cantina. And it was like, oh, he's going to be a human size. And, well, it looks bluish. We'll do it blue. And then it turns out he's like half size and it's
red.
Kind of like a red. So those sort of stories I like. So
that would
I don't
be
know.
So cool.
Yeah, maybe a blue snag.
I support that.
Yeah.
I definitely support that. Well, how has another question though? How has the process changed? How has the process of toy making changed over the past 40 years of Star Wars?
A lot of technology.
Yeah, like from Canada now.
Yeah, a lot of technology. I mean, a lot of the sculpting was obviously done in wax and make molds from that up until pretty recently, up until even like 5, 6, 7 years ago. And now everything's digital. I mean, we're fortunate enough that when the actors go on set, they jump into a room and they get scanned, and we'll use that 3D data to start our sculpts. So that really helps for likenesses and kind of getting all the folds of the material. So that's a big change. That makes things happen a lot quicker. But at the end of the day, it's still about getting a piece of paper on a table and drawing out what's the play going to be, who should we do, how's this vehicle going to work, and kind of scrabbling around and just trying to think of play features that, you know, we know kids from 4 to 44 are going to love. So I think Mark Hamill said it best, everything's changed, but nothing's changed. And that's the same in the toy industry as well.
You've got a cool job, Steve.
Thank you.
And I really like what you guys are doing over at
Hasbro.
Thank you so much for coming by.
Absolute pleasure.
And we'll be right back with more from Celebration Orlando on the Star Wars Show Live, presented by Verizon. I'll see you soon.